Welcome to Elops Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, I want to compare the simple edge finder against a more expensive centering indicator. The difference in price is about 10 times, and I wanted to see how accurate I can set the center of a bore with the edge finder and then the center of the bore with the centering indicator. So what I've done is bored a bore on the milling machine, set my DRO to zero in X and Y without moving the machine, and then put a collet holder in the mill and test each of the devices to see how accurate they are. So let's go into the workshop, see how it worked. These are the two parts we're going to test today, and what I'm looking for is which is more accurate to find the centre of a bore, the edge finder or the centering indicator. There's a difference of about 10 times the cost from the edge finder to the centering indicator. Let's have a look at the edge finder. Works by these two pieces held together with a spring going through the middle, and as it's turning around in the machine, it's concentric. You touch the edge, and as it pushes it across, all of a sudden this will offset like that and show that you've touched the edge. When this is being used, you're looking at this part here to see when it kicks out from being concentric to eccentric. Now on the centering indicator, have a dial indicator on the end of a spindle, and as you touch the side of a bore with the probe, it levers against this center in there and pulls the spindle down, which gives you a reading on the dial indicator. Now the reading you get is not an accurate reading, it's not one to one. Depending on the size of the probe that you put in, the length, it will change the reading. So all you're looking for on the dial indicator is that you get the best or the least run out possible. This actually pivots. If I take the protecting ring off, this pivots on this point here. The leverage is from the centre of that pin down to the end of this arm, and obviously that's not one to one on the indicator. It's a centering indicator, so it doesn't give you an actual figure to say that that's the run out. It'll just tell you the best position you've got to be on center. I've just fitted my boring head into the mill spindle, and I'm putting the tool in. This one is just a carbon tungsten tip. The only thing I've modified on this is I've put a flat on these, the diameter, so I can locate it in the same position with the grub screw. What I found, without the flat, the grub screws are marking the diameter and making it difficult to put back in or take out. So now with a flat on, it goes in easy, tighten the screw up and it will centralise itself. And to alter the position, I just tighten this up or slacken it off, and it'll pull this part of the boring head in or out to give me the diameter I need. So I'm going to lower it down, turn this by hand so I can see roughly where to set the I can see straight away that diameter's too big, so I need to pull the tool in towards the centre. trying to do is get the tool roughly in the centre of this bore. Just double check the tool's tight. Now that's just on the edge of the hole, that side. There. So what I want to do is lower the tool into the bore and just get it centralised and just bore that out to give me a nice finish. And once I've got the bore finished, I'll then zero my X and Y axis and use that as the datum for the next test on the centre finders. I'll just go down into the bore. Once I've bored this, set my digital readout to zero in both axes, so I know that is the true centre. Now I have a register that is on centre. I'll zero my X and Y axis, so I know the spindle is on centre to that bore. Zero my X, Y. Now I'll take the boring head off. Now the first thing I'm going to try, replace the boring tool with a collet holder. And we'll just try a standard edge finder, which when I touch the edge will show that the machine is set to the edge. First thing we need to know is what the bore size is. I fitted the edge finding device in the collet, lowered it down into the bore. Now I want to try and centre this bore and then refer it back to the original zero to see how accurate the centre finder is. This is running around 600 RPM. It just kicked out there. Now go across to the other side. I've taken three readings off each side of the bore in the x-axis. Calculating the average of the two sides in the x-axis gives me a reading of 14.143 and 14.261. So if I add the two together and add the 4mm of the spindle, that gives me a bore size of 32.404. If I come down to the centre again, go back to zero and do the other way, it's back on zero. Now I'll do this side. Across the other side. Right, let's work some of the figures out. If I take the readings for the y-axis, the diameter calculated to 32.413 and the bore size was 32.345, and that gives a difference of 0.068 millimeters, about 2.5 thou. And calculating the x-axis, the diameter was 32.404 and the actual bore size was 32.345, which gives a difference of 0.059, which is just over 2 thou. I'll take the edge finder out and replace it with the centering indicator. Okay, I've fitted my centering dial indicator in. I'll turn it round by hand first, I don't want any surprises. I've just spotted something and I hope others have spotted it. Centering indicator, I've still got the packaging strip in there which should have taken out. This packaging strip, what it does, it stops the dial indicator working properly. I don't think it will make any difference because it's such a small run out, but on a large run out it limits the travel. Let's have a look what I get now when I run that. My XY axis is still set at zero, which is the centre of the bore. I can't see why it's getting a run out there, so let me see if I can reduce the run out by altering the axis. I spent about 3 or 4 minutes on that, altering it, and that's the best I can get. According to this gauge, that is on centre, so the best I can get it. Each division on there is 0.01 of a millimetre. That's running out about 0.01 of a millimetre, which is probably half a thou. 0.01 millimetres and 0.02 millimetres.
That's the bore offset to the centering indicator centre position.
Both the edge finder and the centering device use the same ER20 collet and the same ER20 holder. So any run out from the collet or the spindle would be the same on both parts. So let's sum up and have a look at the results for each indicator. First of all, the edge finder, it was offset by 0.029 millimeters in the x-axis
and in the y-axis it was offset by 0.034 millimetres to the true centre. And the centering indicator had an offset of 0.01 millimetre in the x-axis and 0.02 millimetres in the y-axis. Well, there we are, two different methods of centering a bore. You'll just have to work out whether it's worth paying 10 times more than the other one for the accuracy you get. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting, hope it's useful, and we'll see you next time on Enon's Engineering.